Hello everybody and welcome to DokuSnap. Today I will show you the IT security features of DokuSnap. The IT security section in DokuSnap contains the permission analysis for Exchange, NTFS and so on. That's not only exciting but also very important to secure yourself, to comply with legal requirements and of course for audits. DokuSnap's comprehensive and automatic inventories provide the perfect basis for a complete permission analysis. The basis for an NTFS permission analysis, for example, are a Windows and an Active Directory scan, and also a special NTFS analysis. This way, it is possible to analyze all effective permissions of users and groups in the NTFS structure. But we can not only analyze NTFS and CFS, but also SharePoint and Exchange. In the Exchange environment, for example, it is possible to analyze and evaluate all permissions on the different mailboxes. But why do we need three different inventories for just one evaluation? Quite simple. The NTFS scan identifies the different directories, including the access rights and the inheritance. The AD scan adds the Active Directory structure, meaning the groups, and the group nesting. And finally, the Windows scan gives an overview of the different shares. By bringing these three results together, we get a comprehensive overview of the effective permissions of all users and groups on all folders and shares. But so much for theory, let's check it out in DokuSnap. Here you can see the start screen of DokuSnap. On the left-hand side, there are the different sections of DokuSnap. And on the top, you find the interactive ribbon bar. And down here, the Data Explorer. I'm moving from the inventory to the IT security section. Open my client, my domain, the file system, choose a server. And here I have the departments. Choosing the procurement, I get a first overview of the permissions to the share. Since I want more detailed information, I open the directory report wizard up here. The wizard offers various possibilities to modify the report according to my requirements. In our example, two levels are sufficient and I exclude the domain administrators. Now have the possibility to schedule the execution of this report periodically and to send it directly to a responsible person. However, for our example, I don't need a schedule. I want to create the report right now. Just a few seconds later, I get a detailed report about the effective user's permissions. If you look at the directory permissions, you will often find users that shouldn't have permissions to this share at all. But where do these permissions come from? Let's analyze that together in DokuSnap. For example, I would like to know where our colleague R. Edmonds gets his permissions from, and I enter his name here. And a clever feature of the search field is that the input is directly compared with the Active Directory data, and so I can be sure that's the correct colleague. And immediately I see a list of his effective permissions. But even more exciting than this flat list, I personally consider the permission origin. Here I have really shown in detail how the effective permissions of r.admins are combined. In our example, the question arises, what other permissions does r.admins have and with which other users are they comparable? Let's have a look. First of all, I add a second user I want to compare r.admins permission with. I take our colleague a.cole from the Active Directory again, and then I move to file system. Here I open the user report wizard And this wizard also gives me many possibilities to individualize my evaluation. Our example, all these settings fit to me and I click create. Just lasts a few seconds until the report opens. And this report gives me now a detailed comparison of the individual permissions of the two users. As you can see, there are many different scenarios for the DokuSnap permission analysis. I hope I was able to give you an insight in the topic. Thanks for watching and bye-bye.